The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down. Up the big lake they call Get Sugar Man. The lake, it is said, never gives up for dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. But the load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That big ship and true was a bum to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with the crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. Later that night when the ship's bell rang, it'd be the north wind they'd been feeling. The wind in the wild made a tattletale sound and a wave broke. Every man knew as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. Supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, fellas, it's too rough to feed you. At 7 p.m. the main hatchway gave in. He said, fellas, it's been good to know you. The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the big ship and crew was in peril. And later that night when his lights went out of sight, in the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn in minutes to hours? The searchers all say they made Whitefish Bay. They put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up, but they might have capsized. They may have broke even double water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. In the rooms of their ice water mansion, old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen. Farther below Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. The iron boats go as the mariners all know, with the gales of November remember. Steel hull in Detroit, they prayed in a maritime sailor's cathedral.
The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times. The rich man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Kitchigoomy. Superior, they say, never gives up for dead when the gales of November come early. There was a time in this fair land when the railroad did not run, when the wild majestic mountains stood alone against the sun. Long before the white man and long before the wheel, when the green dark forest was too silent to be real. But time has no beginnings and the history has no bounds. As to this verdant country they came from all around. They sailed upon her waterways and they walked the forest tall. Built the mines, the mills and the factories for the good of us all. And when the young man's fancy had turned into the spring, the railroad men grew restless for to hear the hammers ring. Their minds were overflowing with the visions of their day, with many a fortune won and lost and many a debt to pay. Seaboards and into their hands. Look away, said they, across this mighty land, from the eastern shore to the western strand. Bring the workers and bring up the rails. We gotta lay down the tracks and tear up the trails. Open your heart, let the lifeblood flow. Gotta get on our way, cause we're moving too slow. Bring in the workers and bring up the rails. We gotta lay down the tracks and tear up the trails. Open your heart, let the lifeblood flow. Gotta get on our way, cause we're moving too slow. Get on our way, cause we're moving too slow. Behind Blue Rocky, the sun is declining. The stars, they come stealing at the close of the day. Across the white prairie, our loved ones lie sleeping. Beyond the dark oceans, in a place far away. We are the navvies who work upon the railway, swinging our hammers in the bright blazing song. Living on stew and drinking
bad whiskey. Mending our backs till the long day.